Hey, and welcome to Discard. Today I'm going to talk about a few different ways that you can use to manage cables in your game room or game collection. Specifically, those cables that are attached to your television and your game systems. Let's take a look. So recently I was working on the TV side of my game room and I decided to really delve into management of my cords because they were all over the place in this big nasty mess and it was just a disgusting problem. Part of my problem was that I had a bunch of cords that were sticking out on the top of my TV stand as well as behind some of my shelving units I used for my consoles. But one of the overarching issues that was a real problem was that it was just a big tangled mess behind my TV stand. So I looked for solutions on how to manage that and just make it a more safer location. Now, when it comes to everyone's cord management issues, there really is no catch-all for all of them. After looking into it a bunch of different ways and looking at a bunch of different items, it really depends on what your aesthetics are and how you want to manage your cables and how you're going to be getting to those cables, how often you're going to be moving things, if you want something permanent or you want something to be temporary. And all of those things kind of line up into how you're going to be managing your cables behind you. So definitely keep in mind that all of the ideas I'm going to be showing you are things that work really well for me or ideas that I've come across along the way that happen to be very helpful. So when going to manage my cables, I think it's a pretty good idea to come up with a general idea of what you want to do with your collection, where your cables should be, and what it is in general that you're trying to accomplish. And in general, what I wanted to do was limit the visibility of the cords while also being able to go in there and move these cords and move these systems around whenever I needed to. And as an addition to that, keeping these cords untangled was an absolute must. So to accomplish the first goal that I had, I wanted to take the cords and really fix them to the backsides of the units of which the consoles were in. I have several consoles in my TV stand, but I also have plenty in my Kelax shelves from IKEA. These shelves are actually backless, so you can't simply take the cords and wrap them around the back. So I went ahead and found some small clips on Amazon that would fit between the shelves and on the actual backside of each board of the shelves so that I could attach my cords into those and click these into place, keeping that cord aligned and not seen behind the shelf. Now this definitely won't make it so you cannot see that cord completely because part of your cord is going to be coming from your console to that shelf and there's always going to be that little bit sticking out there. And that's okay. A little bit is not gonna really bother anybody and you're not gonna see too much of it most of the time. But this method will really take care of the majority of that cord and really run it all the way down to the ground so you can have it run to your system or to your television. And I have to say that that idea itself was probably the biggest one out of all of them because it really managed the amount of cords that I was seeing when I was sitting down on my couch, looking at my TV screen or even looking at the consoles. Usually I was looking at all those cords hanging back there behind everything, and now I could look at the LED lighting that I had back there and the consoles themselves. And of course, another thing you can do to kind of manage this backless shelf issue is just taking those items that you have in that shelf and putting them in very ideal locations. Just by taking some items maybe on the base of the shelf and putting them in a more prominent location, you can kind of hide some of those cords that are running down the side. So in general, when you're thinking outside the box and trying to manage where your cords are going, just trying to think of all the different ways that you can keep these cords from being seen is probably the best way to go. Now, in my personal setup for my TV, I have a tremendous amount of cords that are going to different systems in there and going to my television and going to HDMI switchers and all sorts of different things back there. So that was the biggest hurdle for me to get over. One of the first things I did was put this cable concealer along the wall between my TV stand and the shelves that I have. This helps me to really manage those cables that are coming from my shelves to my TV stand and into my HDMI switcher or TV. These little cable hiders are this hard plastic. They have a little part that goes over the front so you can slide that off and insert your cables into it and really hide them. If you have a ton of different cables, it may not be the right size for you. So definitely look into how many cables you have and what the size of them are on Amazon. Now for the backside of my TV stand, I wanted to make sure that all of my cords, the majority of the cords and everything would be attached to the backside of that stand and be really up off the ground and in their own little attachment locations. The only cord that I wanted to have attached to the ground or on the ground was the one from the actual power strip. So as a great starting point for this, having a bigger power strip with USB attachments as well as your regular attachments is a really good investment. Having that longer cord is really good as well. So you can move that TV stand away from the wall and have plenty of room to work while also being able to test different connections and have it plugged in. But overall, please be safe when you're moving cords around and try to disconnect that electricity while you're working on these cords behind your TV. So the first thing that I did when I went to manage these cords was take all of the cords that were coming out of my HDMI router and then attach them into these little rubberized clips. I attached these little rubberized clips to the backside of my TV stand and they would hold those cords in a nice organized way. And this would allow me to have those cords kind of lay more flat to the top of my TV stand and in that way be less visible and just more clean. These little clips are actually pretty cool. They're rubberized and you can just take your cord and attach them into them and plug it in and take it out anytime you want. The biggest problem that I find with these products is that the actual tape will give up on you. So I definitely recommend looking into 3M's more heavy duty tapes for this kind of thing because it's gonna be holding a lot of cords and that's a lot of pressure for it. So otherwise you may have this kind of pop off the backside of your TV stand, especially on warm or hot days. I personally ended up using 3M's double-sided mounting tape for this purpose, but there are certainly a lot more different types of tape out there. Some of them are completely clear and more solid, so it's easier to get off. Whereas the mounting tape is kind of one of those more difficult tapes to get off in the end. When it comes to the backside of my TV stand, the residue is not my first priority, so I kind of went with the double-sided tape regardless of in the future having to deal with that residue. But after using this technique, I was really happy with the results because it really cleaned up those cords and made it look a lot more professional on the top side of the TV stand, which was highly visible in my game room. And the next thing I did when it came to cord management was look at each cord as if I was going to be moving them at different times. I kind of had to assign different priorities to each cord depending on when I was going to be using it or if it was more likely that I was going to be moving that console out more often. Or for instance, with the television itself, if I was gonna be moving that at all. And in the end, you kind of have to put the lower priority stuff, the stuff you're gonna be moving the least, on the bottom of all the other cords. And just managing your cords in that way is a really big deal because it can help you to not tangle your cords in the long run. Just taking out a cord once in a while can be the thing that wraps your cord around something else and you end up with a big tangled mess. I essentially took every cord and kind of wrapped it up to a length that would allow it to be attached to the backside of my TV stand, but also plug into the power brick. Now, once you get them all wrapped up, you'll want to use some sort of tie to kind of attach them to themselves so you can kind of keep that loop. What ended up working the best for me are these Velcro ties. These Velcro ties are fantastic because you can wrap them around the cords and unfasten them anytime you want. These are super simple and very inexpensive. You can find them from a ton of different manufacturers on Amazon, and they're just a simple material of Velcro. So you can find these anywhere, even at your local Best Buy should have them, and they are definitely fantastic. A lot of people like to use zip ties as another even cheaper option, and I definitely recommend those as well, but you just have to take a little bit of more care when you are tying those around your cords, because when you go to clip them off in the future, you may snip your cords. So I tried to use zip ties very sparingly, and a lot of times I used it to kind of attach several different cords into one bundle. And that allowed me to keep one long strip of cords that I knew were going to need to be attached to each other. Now, once I had my cords bundled up into little loops and attached to each other, then I knew I was gonna have to attach them to the actual backside of the TV stand. And this is kind of the tricky part. I definitely took some time to go on Amazon and really look around for different cord holders and different clips and a bunch of different things. These are typically very inexpensive, so I recommend going there and getting a bunch of different types of these so that you can kind of manage your own cords and find the best solution for you. I used a wide variety of different clips, including these small black clips that would hold one or two cords at the max, as well as these bigger white ratchet clips, and they work really well for a lot more cords if you want to do that. And since I actually purchased a kit of these kind of rubberized clips, I also used them all over the backside as well when I was routing different cords to different locations on the backside of that TV stand. So as you're managing these cords on the backside of your TV stand, you want to keep these bundles kind of separate. And in a lot of cases, they are going to be going over other bundles, but for the most part, they are going to still be separate because it's just one or two cords passing over each other. The clips themselves I've used to kind of clip those little bundles in place so that you can easily just take those off and get that bundle out of there if you need to. Now, outside of clips, you may also be able to use different hooks, and that might be a great way to kind of just hook those little bundles onto the backside of your TV stand and be done with it. But personally, I ended up using clips just because I wanted to be sure that those cords were going to continue to be attached to the backside of my TV stand, because personally, I don't want to have to be going back there that often. So definitely take your time to look at different types of double-sided tape, as well as different screw or nail options that are out there for holding different cords to the backside of your TV stand. Now, when you're going to also attach your cords to the backside of your TV stand, another big problem is power bricks. One of the things that I knew I was gonna have behind my TV stand was at least a couple inches of space to a few inches. And in that case, I could take those power bricks and attach them to the actual backside of the TV stand. Now, the tape that I actually used to attach those bricks to the backside of my TV stand was a double-sided mounting tape. And I actually ended up taking off the majority of that and reattaching it with this Velcro tape from Command Strips. If you have a giant power brick and you want to attach it to the backside, I would definitely recommend using a bunch of these. Sometimes those power bricks can get hot as well, and that's going to really limit the power of that tape. Another thing before I forget about those power bricks is that you really want to look at them and see where they have air vents and how they're supposed to be oriented, and kind of decide what you're going to be doing with them, because you don't want to cover up anything that's going to allow heat to dissipate from those, especially when they get so warm. But taking those power bricks and attaching them to the backside of the TV stand was one of the best things that I could do, because that really limited the amount of things that were actually on the ground. And so in the end, by simply attaching your cords to the backside of your TV stand in kind of an organized way and taking those power bricks and attaching them back there, you can really clean up that mess of wires that gets all tangled up on the ground. Another problem that I found was when I was routing those cords from my shelves to my TV, that I'd end up with a larger bundle of wires that were coming from that location to the television. The first one that I used was this kind of plastic tubing, and this plastic tubing is super inexpensive and typically used in office environments when those cords are going to be visible no matter what. And the other way that I liked and I ended up using was these fabric covers that kind of wrap around the cords. If you have a ton of cords that are gonna be going all in line with each other, this is a fantastic solution for that. And all you have to do is take this, it has a little bit of Velcro on it, you wrap it around those cords, and then if you have cords that are gonna be splitting off from that bundle, then you can cut a little hole in the side of this and have it route out the side. So one thing is definitely for sure when it comes to managing the cords that are behind your TV stand or your shelving, and that's that it takes a little bit of planning to ensure that in the long run, you're gonna have a lot less to do when you're moving things around. After taking some time with it and spending a couple weeks kind of thinking about the different options that I had for managing those cables, I ended up somewhere that I was very happy with. I used to have cords kind of popping out on the top of my TV stand, and I could certainly see some underneath since my TV stand is raised off of the ground. And now I barely see any of them, and the majority of the cords that I do see are just the last ones that I have to. And I think with enough patience and time, anyone can really do this and kind of find ways to route those cords back there. I just think these are kind of the methods that work for me. So thanks for coming and checking out Discart today. If you have any other ideas for managing cables in a game room or game collection, please let me know in the comments below. I'm absolutely looking for more ideas on how to do that. If you want to help out Discart pass a subscription, please check out patreon.com/discart and check out all the awesome stuff you can get for $2 a month. If you like this video, please leave a like. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe. But otherwise, have a great day and collect what you love. Yeah. To manage cables in my game room or game collection, in my game room or game collection, my game room or game collection. Hey, and welcome to Discart. Today I'm going to talk.